California drag strips produced some of the legends of the sport in the 1960s. The 1933 to 42 Willys were a much sought after production car because of its lightness and styling. With that era thought to be gone,
we move on to the modern day nostalgia movement and present a first time look at today's cars mixing a little old with today's technology and a new generation of drivers who carry on the gangster wars of the 60s all around the country. Like returning legends K.S. Tiger Pittman and his old-powered 40 Williams. Jack Coonrod from the Northwest area with his Willys, which has been in the planning stages for several years, is now issued by Dave Salem. Check out the detail on Coonrod's flip-top 33, a rare sight, as most like to go with the conventional body style. His pickup in 91 and built this coupe, seen in its first match race. Tom Thompson and his son have been around since the 50s and are among the most respected racers in drag racing. They are currently building a new Burgundy Bandit, a 1933 Willy split flip-top coupe for 93. Ronnie Nunes is the latest arrival from the bygone era. He's the fastest of the bunch, having run a 753 ET at Seattle in 92.
Thank you. magic rule.
Thank you.
battle between K.S. Pittman and John Rocha's replica of the Stonewoods and Cook Gassers was seen all over the U.S. We believe K.S. had the edge going in, and although we did not see all of their races, we will let you be the judge. Car or star, it was an exciting match in 1990.
Well, they do. Or you might be able to get a stud.
Can you get a hard stud?
I think they're pretty hard, the ones that tuner, aren't they?
Well, that little study sticks out probably is hard. But that's what happened. The boat came in and popped it on the back then. Well, I see they got a button in it, so it'll back up. Well, it broke it, so it'll back up the full hole. And what you did, Bob, about 10 or 12 degrees. Then it banged the boats a little bit, then it retarded it, whatever. It was probably 16 or 18 degrees it retarded on the
So when they stretched, they let the gear wobble. Gear wobble and started ripping back and forth. He sheared it.
Well, what I need to do is I'm going to put it up. You know, we got that good pressure plate bolts.
Yeah.
They got a shoulder. They got a nice, super
little
shoulder.
Narrow shoulder on
it. Really. It's just hard enough to go right in with you. Well, really.